Well, good Wednesday morning, everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I love that you start your day with inspiration for today, as Diane and I do also. We are in day two of looking at creation. I was studying for it as I teach foundations back in June, and I love this material, and I wanted to share it with you. And I know that a lot of you have been to foundations, but many of you have not. So this section on creation, it just talks about the majesty of God. And you can never get too much of that, because the bigger your God, the smaller your problems, because you know that he can handle them and will see you through them all. There was a quote that I wanted to give yesterday as we looked about into why God created and just the majesty of the stars and all that there is there. I wanted to give you this quote. Albert Einstein said, "Anyone who is not lost in the rapture awe of the power and glory of the mind behind the universe is as good as a burnt out candle." Isn't that something? Brilliant people, if their mind is open at all, they look out at the stars in the universe, and to say this could happen by chance is just absurd. And he just said, who is not lost in rapturous awe of the power and glory of the mind behind the universe. Now, I don't know if Albert Einstein ever discovered the mind behind the universe for himself. I hope he did. But what he said there was absolutely true, wasn't it? For today and the next couple of days, I want to give you seven truths. And isn't that typical of, the Saddleback way? And of course, Foundations was written by Tom Holliday and Kay Warren. Seven truths about creation, foundational to our lives. That's the title they gave to these seven truths. But I would just say that these are seven things about creation that just should get you and me so excited. We're followers of the God that did this. Wow. And I'm just telling you, these are going to build your faith if you let them. All the evidence is there. And as we read from Romans 1 yesterday, all that can be seen of the people are without excuse. God is behind this. He created it. So let me just give you, we're going to give you just two today. But I only want to give two or three at a day, because I really want to mull on them or meditate on these truths. I hope you'll do the same. Here's the first one. Number one, God created everything out of nothing. Did you get that? You see, everything in the universe has a cause and effect, except one thing. The universe itself. It is there was once nothing. And of course, you know, Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, what God created, the heavens and the earth. That was the beginning. John 1:1 says the same thing. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God, and everything was made by him. God created the universe from nothing. Wow. And I do mean nothing. Here's a verse for the day. Hebrews 11:3. And it says this. By faith, we understand that the universe was formed at God's command, so that what is seen was not made out of what was visible. The Bible's so clear. He made everything you see, everything you touch. I can reach out and touch the wall. Why is there a wall? Because there's material. Because there's cement. Because, And all of that exists because God spoke it into existence. And Genesis 1:3, and this verse is repeated throughout Genesis 1, that this thought. And God said, let there be light. And guess what? There was light. That's all it took. God spoke light into existence. Does that awe you? Does that make you just, I mean, I can make a few things when I have the materials and so on, but I can't make the materials. That should fill you with wonder. As we face the realities of life, to think that God could do such a thing. You know, they scientists feel so smart. They have researched, and when we got out there, they have hypothesized that the universe did have a beginning point, and they called it the Big Bang. Well, that's okay. If that's what you, except they're trying to say that because they're trying to take God out of the picture. But if there was a Big Bang, then there was somebody who caused the Big Bang. And that is God of the Bible, Elohim, and in Hebrew. Number two. So God created everything out of nothing. But number two thing we're going to ponder today, creation was done in the exact proper order. The exact proper order. What do I mean by that? You see, God is a God of order, and so that characteristic of his is displayed in all that was done. When you read Genesis chapter 1, let me just read part of it. God said, let there be light, and God called the expanse sky. Let the water under the sky be gathered in one place and dry ground appear, and let the land produce vegetation. And then the land did produce vegetation, plants, seed-bearing according to their kinds. Read through Genesis 1 and look at the order. Look at the order. It was the correct order. It was the order that it had to be. It had to be. And finally, the culmination of that was what? Let's make man in our own image. After everything was there so that man could exist and thrive, then he created mankind. But when you think about it, think of it quickly. Flowers need what? They need bees. And bees need what? Bees need flowers. They need each other. And that symbiotic relationship, both needed to exist so that they could help each other exist. There are so many things like that in nature where if there'd be no way for things, for animals to exist if plants weren't there for them to eat. But guess what? The plants were there for them to eat. Now, God did everything perfectly. He knew the correct order of those 6 days, of those 6 days of creation. We serve a great God. Things are in order. They're in order. Even when things seem out of order in our life, in God's timing, in God's perfect will, they are in order. And that's demonstrated by the order of creation. And that's one of the reasons we're looking this week at creation. I've got two more awe-inspiring things for us to look at tomorrow. Please turn in. See you tomorrow. Walk closely with your Lord today.